All right, so we have a giant matrix A and another smaller 2x2 matrix B. And in this video, we're going to use np.where to change and manipulate the matrices how we want. Now, np.where can take in up to 3 parameters, the array of booleans, an array of values to keep, and a replacement array. So I'm going to show you how this works with a few different examples. All right, so let's get going with our examples. First off, we're going to do the matrix B. We'll type np.where and we'll give it a mask where B is greater than 0. And we'll hit enter there. And this may not seem like anything interesting at first, but let's take a look at B one more time. All right, so what this gave back was actually the indices where the value is indeed true. So B greater than 0. So any index where B is greater than 0. You'll notice this 4 right here is indexed at 0, so row 0 and column 0. And that is indeed greater than 0. And this 1 at row 1, column 0 is greater than 0. So that's why it gives back a 0, 0 and a 1, 0. All right, let's do a similar thing with A. This time we'll do less than 0. So this is obviously a much bigger array, so there's a lot of indices. You can see that the indices line up with where the negative numbers are. And moving right along, all right, we'll do np.where of B greater than 0 to keep the values of B and replace any values where it's not true with negative 1. All right, so B greater than 0. So the only places where B is greater than 0 is the 4 and 1. And so you'll see that those stayed the same. The 4 and the 1 are the same because we put B as the keep. Negative 1 we put as the replacement. So anywhere where it was less than 0, so it didn't meet that condition, is now filled in with a negative 1. All right, here's A once again. Let's do np.where A is less than 0. We'll keep A and we'll replace it with the value 100. So every time it's less than 0, it stayed just like the original A. And any time it's greater than 0, so it didn't match the condition, it was replaced with the number 100. Now the replacement doesn't have to be a single number. You can actually give it an array of numbers. So let's go ahead and move along to that. So we'll do np.where. We'll give it B greater than 0. We'll keep B if that's the case, and we'll replace it with a different and new array. So B greater than 0, we keep B if that's the case, and if not, we replace with this array on the end, just full of zeros. And I didn't have to put all zeros in that case. So that negative 2 and negative 1 are now replaced with the zeros in that second array. And to illustrate this one more time, we'll do np.where A is greater than 0. A is going to be what we keep if that's the case. And our replacement will be a random array that's the same size as our original A. So if A is greater than 0, then we keep the original A. And if it's not greater than 0, we replace with a random number. So remember all those negatives at the beginning? Now we have a 0.708. a 0.406, and so on. But the positive numbers are still the same. So there you have it. That is how you can use NumPy's where function to manipulate arrays how you desire. Please be sure to check out some of my other Python videos, and don't forget to hit subscribe.